गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वील डिस्कस अबाउट द डायमेंशनल प्रॉपर्टी। हाउ मेनी प्रॉपर्टीज आर देयर? थ्री प्रॉपर्टीज आर देयर। वन इज चेक द करेक्टनेस ऑफ द फॉर्मूला, सेकेंड वन इज योर कन्वर्जन ऑफ यूनिट, थर्ड वन इज डेरिवेशन ऑफ द फॉर्मूला। सो लेट अस फर्स्ट चेक द करेक्टनेस ऑफ द फॉर्मूला। एंड वन फॉर्मूला इज देयर, एस इज इक्वल टू यू टी प्लस आर पी टी स्क्वायर। S equal to ut plus r pt square. This is kinematic equation. How many equation is there? Kinematic equation. V is equal to u plus at. Already I have discussed. Then second equation is S equal to ut plus r pt square. Third equation, v square minus u square, 2s. One more equation is there. You know? You don't know? Sm equals to u plus a by 2 whole into 2 minus 1. This is the fourth equation of the motion. First equation is v is equal to u plus a t. Second equation, s equal to u2 plus half a t square. Third equation is v square minus u square 2as. Fourth equation is sn equals to u plus a by 2 whole into 2n minus 1. Fourth equation is there. So first we have already discussed about the v is equal to u plus a t. Now let me discuss s equal to u plus half a t square. How many term is there? Three term. S is one term, u t is another term, half a t square is third term. Okay. In the LHS, here s equal to u t plus half a t square means what? S is in LHS, u t plus half a t square in RHS. So in LHS, which term is there? S. So what is the dimension of the S? Dimensional formula: m 0 l 1 t 0. S means what? It's a length. So dimensional formula, there is no mass, there is no time. So m 0 t 0 directly. Suppose you can write l 1 also, this is also correct. Now the second term, that is ut in RHS, in RHS ut is there. What is u? Dimensional formula, the u, and dimensional formula, the t. So u is equal to m 0 l 1 t minus 1, dimensional formula of the speed, initial velocity, u is equal to initial velocity, dimensional formula of the speed or velocity, m 0 l 1 t minus 1, and next is your t, time period is t. How much then? M 0 l 1, this is t 1, this is t minus 1. What will come? You say, what will come? T minus 1 t 1, t 2, t minus 1 t 1, this is minus 1 plus 1 cancel. So what remains? T 0, it will not come t 2. M 0 L 1 T minus 1, here T 1 is there, I will multiply. So what will I get? T 0. So now U T half A T square. Now dimensional formula, in case of dimensional formula of the half A T square, half is a constant. Constant is ignored because it is dimensionless. That's why directly I am calculating the dimensional formula of the A T square. Again, dimensional formula of the A into dimensional formula of the T square. What I will get? A is equal to M 0 L 1 T minus 2 and T square. Now you see, once again same thing will come, minus 2 here, plus 2. How much will come? 0. That is T minus 2 T 2 multiplied. How much I will get? T 0. So dimensional formula, how I will get? Dimensional formula of the A T square, I will get M 0 L 1 T 0. Now you see, first term is what? L. Next term, L, dimensional formula. Third also I got dimensional formula M 0 L 1 T 0. That means in an equation, in the formula, in an equation, if the all term having same dimensional formula, then the equation is correct, dimensionally correct. So like this you have to check, you check it, that V is equal to U plus A T, I have already checked. S equal to U T plus A T square, also check that this is dimensionally correct. How we could know that dimensionally correct? Because in all terms, in all terms, dimensional formula remaining same. So in S equal to ut plus half a t square, how many term was there? S is one term, ut is second term, half a t square is the third term. So in three term, S dimensional formula, ut dimensional formula, a t square dimensional formula, that coming same, L, here also L, here also L. Like this, whenever you are calculating any equation, equation dimensional formula and dimensional formula remaining same for all term, then only that equation is correct in dimension. So you can check like this. So one of the property of the checking the correctness of the formula shows that if each term in an equation is coming same dimension or same dimensional formula, then it is correct one. One is. Second one is that conversion. Convert one system to other system. Other system. One system to other system. You have to convert the unit. Conversion is second formula or second properties of the dimensional analysis. So, if you think about the conversion, you have to remember some tricks. Okay, some format is there, table is there. You have to remember. So, for the example, one question: convert. Through example only we can discuss. Convert 1 joule into arc. Into arc. Or 1 joule is how much? 10 to the power 7 or what is joule? Unit of work done in SI unit. What is org? CJS unit of work done. That means what is the quantity here? Work done is the quantity whose unit is joule. Joule is the SI unit of work done. Org also unit of work done in the CJS system. So you have to convert 1 joule into org. How much org? Actually what happened? 1 joule is equals to 10 to the power 7 org. This is your answer. You have to convert into what? Joule converted into R. 1 joule is how much R into how much R. So, this is another property. So, let us prove it. So, three format is there. Format you have to follow. First of all, what happened? You have to write the system 1 on the left side and in the middle you write down quantity, then system 2. System 2, okay. System 1, quantity, system 2. I am preparing this system like this. What you can understand it, okay. You can understand. If there is any doubt, you can ask me. System 1, let us say the MK system, okay. SI system, MK system. So, M1 is equal to 1 meter, M1, L1, T1 format you will write. So, M1 means what? Mass or length?
Mass.
So, that is 1 kilogram. L1 is equal to 1. Meter, T1 is equal to 1 second, N1 means I am writing 1 joule means what 1, N1 is 1 here. Now in the quantity, whose quantity is unit is joule or work or whose quantity, which quantity unit is joule or arg, joule is the SI unit, arg is the CJS unit, work done. So that is why work is my quantity, work is equals to what, force into distance Fs. You see, work done is equals to force into distance, yes or no? Force into distance. What is the dimensional formula of the work done? W. Dimensional formula of the force, dimensional formula of the S. Then, what is the dimensional formula of the force? M1, L1, T minus 2. And this is S is L. So, let us multiply it. M1, L2, T minus 2. What is the dimensional formula I got for the work done? M1, L2, T minus 2. So, here I will write dimensional formula of the work done is equals to M1, L2, T minus 2. So, is this mass to the power A, length to the power B, time to the power C. If we consider, then what is A? A is equal to 1. What is B? B is equal to 2. What is C? C is equal to minus 2. Once again, because we are going to convert joule into R. I have to remember, I have to find out that this unit is belongs to which quantity. Joule is the unit of work done. So, I identified the unit of this work done is joule, that is why quantity, in the quantity column I am writing work done formula is force into distance. In dimension, I am writing here. Dimension of the work done is equals to m to the power 1, l to the power 2, t to the power minus 2, that is m1, l1, t minus 2, and you have to enclose the square bracket. This is the format of the dimensional formula. And what is A? Dimension of the mass. What is B? Dimension of the length. C? Dimension of the time. So, A is equal to 1, B is equal to 2, C is equal to minus 2. And I hope I have explained what is the dimensional formula of the work done, how you have got it. Now, system 2 I will write. System 2 is CGS. The right side I will write system 2, it is M2, let it be M2, 1 gram, mass is second in CGS, 1 gram. L2, suppose this is 1 centimeter, T2 as usual this is 1 second, and N2 you have to calculate, you have to find out, right. This is the format, please write down, I will erase it. So, M1, L1, T1, N1, then quantity is in the middle. And next right side I have written M2. So, you can write as your own choice also, in all style also you can write, but I have selected this method so that you can remember easily and it is very easy to what understand. Okay. Now, comparing this equation 1 and 2, suppose comparing this equation according to principle of homogeneity, in dimension what happened? You have to follow the principle of homogeneity, means left side is equals to right side equation, left side dimensional formula is equal to right side dimensional formula. So, that is called as equation of homogeneity, principle of homogeneity. As per the principle of homogeneity, left side dimensional formula must be equal to right side dimensional formula. So, that principle of homogeneity I will use here. So, how according to, I am writing according to principle of homogeneity, I got that left side, right side. How I am using left side, right side and quantity, let us see. I am writing N1 whole into M1 to the power A, L1 to the power B, T1 to the power C. You see, left side I am writing M1, L1, T1, N1. Right side, what I will write? N2 into, again same thing, M2 to the power A, L2 to the power B and T2 to the power C. This is your method or what style, how to write according to the principle of homogeneity. The left side one system 1, left side system 1, right side system 2, system 1 system 2 or MK system, CGS system, how they are going to be equal? Because of the principle of homogeneity. Okay. You can say how it is equal. I can say by using the principle of homogeneity, that power I have. Okay. So, it can be equal to each other. Now, I will be raising this. Now, what I have to calculate? N2 have to calculate. Question was that 1 joule into or let us consider one joule, out of 1 joule, 1 is the N1, how much org, matlab dash org, dash is your N2. That is why N2 if you calculate, what will happen? This is the mathematics, N1, I will write this part, M2, L2, T2, this part, this total part will come to right side, left side and it will get divided, yes or no? So, what will happen? M1 by M2 to the power A, L1 by L2 to the power B, T1 by T2 to the power C. Okay. You got it? N2 you have to calculate. So, this part converted and divided. So, I divided M1, M2 divided with M1, L1 divided to M2, L2. Now, you got it. Now, the time came to put the value. You can put the value. What is the value of N1? CN10?
1.
1, very good. This is 1. It was 1. Now, what is value of M1? 1 kg I think, right? 1 kg. M2 is 1 gram, whole to the power A, but A is what? 1. You see, in the quantity column, A, B, C value was given, A is equal to 1, B is equal to 2, C is equal to minus 2. You see it. So, here I can put in place of A, 1. Then it is L1, L1 is what? 1 meter by 1 cm. This is your 2. This is 1 second by 1 second divided by minus 2. This format up to this stage clear. Now, 1 as usual, 1 kilogram gram is that, have to equalize. 1 kilogram, how much gram? 1000 gram. So, I will write 1000 gram. divided by 1 gram to the power 1. Now it is also 100 cm. 1 meter means 100 cm by 1 cm to the power 2. This is 1 second by 1 second to the power minus 2. Now everything cancel, gram gram cancel, cm cm cancel, second second cancel. Now just think, if just only calculation part, last part is there. How much come? I'll write here, space will be there. N2 is equals to 1, 1000 to the power 1, 1000 I can write in the power form, 10 to the power 3. Yes. So 10 to the power 3 to the power 1, okay. Now 10 to the power 2 to the power 2, 1 to the power minus 2. Is it correct? So 1000, 10 to the power 3 and power 1 is there. Then 100, 10 to the power 2 to the power minus to the power 2, 1 to the power minus 2. Now directly you can calculate it. How much you will get? You say 4, finally n2 is equals to 1 into 10 to the power 3 whole into 10 to the power 2 2 ja, how much? 4. So 10 to the power 4 into 10 to the power minus 2, how much? 1 to the power, sorry, 1 to the power minus 2, how much? 1 or minus 1? 1 to the power 1, 1. 1 to the power minus 1, 1 or minus 1? Not minus 1, 1. 1 to the power anything is equal to, okay. That is 1. 1 to the power minus 2, I am writing 1. That is doubt, I think. Yes or no? Doubt. How I got 1 to the power minus 2 is equal to 1? If there is doubt, I will clarify it. I will do it. Okay. 1 to the power minus 2. He has doubt, so I am clarifying. 1 to the power minus 2, that is 1 to the power 1 by 2 to the power. In the reciprocal, I am doing. 1 to the power minus 2, can I write 1 by 1 to the power 2? Yes. Okay. Now 1 to the power 2, how much? 1 or not? 1 by 1, how much? 1. Now clear? Now how much? Multiply n2 is equal to 10 to the power 3, 10 to the power 4, how much? 10 to the power 7. What is the value got? N2 value, 10 to the power 7. So 1 joule, how much are? 10 to the power 7 are. So in the last, you write down 1 joule is equals to 10 to the power 7 or hence. We have converted one system to another system from joule to org. Joule was the SI unit of work done, org was the CJ unit of work done. So, 1 joule is equivalent to how much org? 10 to the power 7 org by like this. I hope, no doubt. In second example, one more example you can do. I think it will be better, huh? You can understand better. Okay, let us do. Convert another example let us convert 1 newton into dam 1 newton into dam that means this is the question convert 1 newton into dam after that answer what I will get 1 newton is equals to actually 10 to the power 5 dam Newton is what? Unit of force. Newton is SI unit of force. Dyne is CJ unit of force. So, what is the quantity here? Force is the quantity here. So, just that format I am writing. The system 1, that is M1 is equal to 1 kilogram, same thing. L1 is equal to 1 meter. T1 is equal to 1 second. N1, I am writing this N1. 1 Newton means N1 is. How much is? 1. Now in the middle, second quantity. I am writing quantity. This is the force is the quantity here. Force equal to mass into acceleration. Force equal to mass into acceleration. F for father, M for ma. Father is equal to ma. Or what? Huh? So force is equal to M into A. So dimensional formula of the force is equals to how much I'll get? M1, L1, T minus 2. You got it? Here, MLT that power is ABC. A is equal to 1, 1 here. B is equal to what? 1 here. C is equal to what? Minus 2. So, A is equal to 1, B is equal to 1, C is equal to minus 2. Okay, you can write like this. Now system 2 suggests m2 is equals to how much? 1 gram. L2 is how much? 1 cm. T2 is equal to how much? 1 second. N2 you have to calculate the same format whatever it was in joule to org, same format. Now we can do. Now which principle you have to use? Applying principle of homogeneity. What is that? Homogeneity. Homogeneity is equality. Homo means what? Equal. Similarity. So left side, whatever the quantities are there, whatever the units are there, whatever the values are there, should be equal to right side values. That is called as principle of homogeneity. Okay. So here also we can use, by using the principle of homogeneity, we can write n1 all into m1 to the power a, l1 to the power b, t1 to the power c, which is equals to n2 m2 to the power a, l2 to the power b, t2 to the power c. Okay. Did I change anything? Nothing. In the previous question it was same thing, same format. Here one more important thing is that, interesting thing is that, that once you remember this format, there will be no wrong. You can write correctly in exam. Okay, only you have to remember the format. Okay, you have to follow the format. Now because space, there is no space, I have to remove it. Okay, you help me, what are the terms are there? Now what you have to calculate? N2 you have to calculate, because 1 newton kilo dash dyne, you have to convert it. What is it? What is this? 1 is equal to N1 in the dash, N2 is there. Okay. So let us calculate. N2 is equals to, therefore N2 is equals to N1, this part, this total part, it will come and get divided here. Okay. So N1 into M1 by M2 whole to the power A, L1 by L2 whole to the power B, T1 by T2 whole to the power C. Okay. Now put the value, get the answer. Now put the value, get the answer. Now N1 is equal to how much? N is equal to 1. N1 is equal to N, 1. M1, this is 1 kg by 1 gram whole to the power 1. It is 1 meter by 1, how much, centimeter to the power 1, and 1 second by 1 second to the power minus 2. In previous what happened, 1, 2, minus 2, A was 1, B was 2, C was minus 2. Here A is 1, B is 1, C is minus 2. So exactly find out N2 is equals to 1. Abhi 1000 gram, 1 kilogram equal to 1000 gram, convert it. 1000 gram by 1 gram to the power 1, 100 cm by 1 cm to the power 1, 1 second by 1 second to the power minus 2. Abhi, this gram gram will be cancelled, second second will be cancelled. What happened, Vishi? I hope the last stage is coming. You cancel it, find out N2 is equals to 1. Now this is 1000, 1000 means what? 10 to the power 3, 100 means what? 10 to the power 2, that right I am doing. This is 1 means what? 1 to the power minus 2 is 1. If I will write N2 is equals to 10 to the power 3 into 10 to the power 2, how much? 10 to the power 5 or not? Radical, 10 to the power 3 into 10 to the power 2, 3 plus 2, that is 5, 10 to the power 5. So I got it. N2 is equal to how much? 10 to the power 5. Proved or not? So, it is very important to remember how to convert one system of unit to another system of unit. Clear? Any doubt? No doubt, sure. So, like this, if you will follow this format, what format you have to follow? You have to follow, first of all, you have to identify the quantity. Identify the quantity. Jessica, that means what? 1 joule into R. Joule is the unit of which quantity? 1 newton into dyne, or question may reverse, convert dyne into Newton, org into joule. Okay, I am talking about this is the work done quantity, force is the quantity. In different questions, different format will come. Okay, check. Next property, you have to convert one formula. Okay, it is very important. Sometimes you have to follow the rules, principle you have to follow. What is that third property of the dimensional analysis? It was second. The third property of the dimensional analysis, okay, you have to derive the formula. Okay, what's problem will be there, and there you have to find out what is given, what are the different quantity, what you have to calculate, you have to write. Suppose one formula is there, one expression that circle, I have to draw the circle, not looking like circle. Okay, adjust it. This is center, this is A, just of a circle. Before explaining that question, you should know this, that suppose in a circular path a body is moving, okay, around a fixed, this are the distance, it is a fixed point, O is the fixed point, origin, and A, then the body is moving with velocity V. Okay, some force is required to change the position of the body to B position. Now the velocity is V, linear velocity. This velocity is linear velocity. So what force required to circulate the body around a fixed point? Centripetal force. That force is called as what? Centripetal force, right? So centripetal force helps the body to move around this. So question is that the centripetal force, depending upon centripetal force F, C, suppose, depending upon what factor? Depending upon mass of the body which is moving. Suppose M is the mass of the body at the A position A, now it is moving, centripetal force helping to reach here up to B, now it is coming to C position, now it coming to D position, now different position it is coming, and ultimately it is coming to A. Now this body is circulating, centripetal force is helping. That means centripetal force depending upon mass of the body and velocity or speed of the body, now the speed, linear velocity, and radius from the center, from the fixed point. So this is the equation. Centripetal force, question is what? Centripetal force depending on mass of the circulating body, velocity with which it is circulating, and radius from which it is moving. So M to the power A, V to the power B, R to the power C, let it be. So you have to derive a formula, centripetal force, you have to derive the formula of the centripetal force. So FC, centripetal force, is equal to, let it be K, K is the constant, I remove the proportional sign, K, M to the power A, V to the power B, R to the power C. By using dimensional analysis, I will find the equation or the formula of the centripetal force. In advance, I will tell centripetal force formula is equals to K mv square by R. This is your formula. You have to derive it. You have to derive it. Okay. Now, the formula up to question is given. The centripetal force is depending upon the mass, velocity, and radius. So, because I know how to write the formula, I am writing here centripetal force is depending upon mass to the power A, V to the power B, R to the power C. So centripetal force is equals to K M A V B R C. When you will finally you will derive, what we should get? F C is equal to M V square by R. Centripetal force formula is what then? M V square by R. So you have to prove it. Now here also you have to follow some principle or rule, just like the conversion. What you have to do? Suppose FC is equals to, FC means what? Centripetal force. I am writing C for centripetal force. M to the power K, M to the power A, V to the power B, R to the power C. This was the equation. Equation 1, yes or no? Main equation. Now the left side, right side, you have to compare the dimensional analysis. What is that? In LHS, what is F is the centripetal force. Dimensional formula you have to calculate. Centripetal force may be gravitational, whatever the force may be, dimensional formula will be remain same. That is m1 l1 t minus 2. So m1 l1 t minus 2 is the dimensional formula of the force. Okay. In right side you see, in RHS, k is the constant. In this equation, what is this? K. K is the constant. So there is no dimension. Now I will find the dimension of m, v, and r. M, v, and r. So in RHS, m to the power a, v to the power b, r to the power c. So totally dimension I will write. What that? What is the m? M for what? Mass or not? M for mass. So I am writing here mass m to the power a. Okay. A, just write down outside of the bracket because the dimension. Are you getting or not? Then v, please help me. What is v?
Velocity.
Dimensional formula m0 l1 t minus 1. M0 l1 t minus 1. So I'll write here m0 l1 t minus 1. Carefully just listen, you will understand. Now what is the dimension? B, whole to the power b I am writing here. Next, what, which term? R, r to the power c, sorry, r is the length. So what I will write? L to the power c. So m to the power a, I have written here for m a, b b is there, so b is the velocity. For that I am writing m0 l1 t minus 1 to the power b, and r is the length, l to the power c. Here I can write l t also 0 0. Here I can write m t m 0 l 1 t 0. So shortcut in right hand. Now what happened is just correlate, collect the power of the mass. Here mass a, mass 0 into b 0, there is no mass at all, so m a is remain. Now length is there, l to the power b, l to the 1 into b, how much? B. Now l is there, c, so b plus c, then t minus b. This is your final dimensional formula for this. Left side dimensional formula m1 l1 t minus 2. Right side dimensional formula m to the power a, l to the power b plus c, t to the power minus b. Now again principle of homogeneity. According to principle of homogeneity, right side dimension of the mass a should be equal to left side dimension of the mass 1. Here length dimensional formula is how much? Dimension is how much? B plus C. Right side, left side how much? It is 1. So B plus C is 1. So we will find it, we will get an equation. Okay, equation. How we will get the equation? You see, here I will write m to the power a, right side dimension, this a should be equal to 1. So a is equals to 1. Getting point? Now B plus C. B plus C is equal to what? Huh? 1. Very good. B plus C equals to 1. Means length dimension right side, length dimension left side sum. Now T minus B, that is minus B is equals to minus 2. This is equation 1, this is equation 2, this is equation 3. After solving equation 1 and 2, I will get value of ABC and I will put this equation. Now solve this equation. I have a is equals to 1 already as a minus b from 3, from equation 3, minus b is equal to minus 2. So b is equal to how much then? 2. I got b is equal to 2. I have already a is equal to 1 in the equation 1. So b plus c is equal to 1. So I can find out the value of c. How much? So b plus c is equal to 1. So c is equals to 2 is how much? 1 minus 2, then will be minus 1. Once again, b plus c is equal to 1. I got the value of b is equal to 2. So what is the value of c then? 1 minus 2. Are 2 plus c is equal to 1, c is equal to 1 minus 2, that is minus 1. So I got a is equal to 1, b is equal to 1, sorry, b is equal to 2, c is equal to minus 1. Now putting the value, ऐसे लिखो putting the values of a is equal to 1, b is equal to how much 2, and c is equal to minus 1 in equation fc equals to k ma vb rc, then what will get? Fc is equals to k m to the power, what is a is equal to 1, b to the power b 2, r to the power c minus 1. That implies fc is equals to k mb square by r. This is the derived required formula. This is the derived formula. Then what I told you, the centripetal force formula will come k mb square bar. I proved or not? K mb square bar. This is the derivation of the formula equation by using dimensional analysis. It is the very very important property. It comes in exam. You have to prepare it. Okay.